Okay, hello guys, it should be working already. Let me double check, closing this and reopening. And of course producing the audio while also opening Discord.
Okay,
hello guys, it should be working already. Let me double check, closing this and reopening. And of course producing the audio. Alright, placing myself in Discord, already started Joy2Key. I know that Discord works because by now I use it every day, never change the source of the audio, so no need to test that. Okay, let's play Sturm Week again. It's been a while. It's been a while, I feel like the time has come. I'm actually trying to do it with the VR overlay again, even though I had settled back on using just the cell phone. But it's so annoying every time to look underneath the visor. I would rather not have to do it. Let's see. I have come to that conclusion because it seemed to make the game run better. But since some time has passed, I want to be an optimist. Maybe it will work well. Anyway, they're making a new patch for this game, which seemingly should make it run better. They say they're improving performance by reducing, they say, anti-aliasing just a bit. And apparently this makes a huge difference. Well, okay, I say, the sooner you do it, the better, because this game, as you know, doesn't run extremely well. Unfortunately, it's one of its greatest problems, especially in VR. It's just not optimized for VR, but after all, it wasn't born for the purpose of playing in VR. Okay, anyways, it's starting. I already did the thing where I recentered my EPD, because having played with the Oculus, it was wrong, no? It had the Oculus EPD. And in theory it should work. Look at this, almost full server. They raised the player cap, now up to 84. Is this game getting more popular or am I wrong? I don't know, I see more people playing at all days, all hours of the days. Well, I say it's about damn time, because it's a very good game. And another of its weak points is case in point, the smaller player base compared to War Thunder. So if they really improve performance and in the meantime more people start to play it, well then we could have the perfect flying game right here. The perfect flying game indeed. Who is this friend that plays? This one, I know him, he's an Italian friend, but he doesn't play it often. And this one is Dark Hunter 82. I don't remember you. We must have played together, but I don't remember you. Okay. Let's see, I have a good Russian, to tell you the truth, but let's see. Ooh, this has even the Allies plane, yes. So we have a later war scenario. Even cooler, even cooler. I will go Allies and pick. It's not a late war scenario. No. Hey, hello. Bruce, thank you for liking the stream. We're going to play on Wings of Liberty, like I used to so often sometimes ago, and well, I say it's about time we do it again. Let's start with a fighter. Yeah, it's more classical. Yak 1, Lag 3, that's all, right? Nothing newer. I said it was a later war scenario, not anything but Yak 1, MiG 3, PA2, MiG 3. It's only the very, very early planes. Okay, I won't go from where it's already under attack. Let's go with the Yak 1, a classic. In terms of armaments, do we want to carry rockets? I mean, we can reduce the... How's the weather? The weather is summer, so we can go already. And let's play Sturm Week again. I say, it's about damn time after so many weeks. Everything is set correctly, also I hope, I best not speak too soon, after all this is a troublesome game at time. How's my frame rate? Well, for this game it's acceptable. I'm also still at the airfield. Okay, the APD is indeed correct. Yes, well, maybe when you use this zoom it's not perfect, but anyway, why would you use the minimum level of zoom? I would use only the maximum level of zoom. Okay, starting the engine. Look at the A20 to my left. Where is he starting? Only him, it seems. Okay, how long has this been running? Quite a bit, because it ends in only 40 minutes. Well, I say it's good, so we will have a different setting before long. Let me do one thing. It's annoying to have this thing here. And the engine is running. Close the canopy. I didn't increase the RPM. It's incredible that the engine started, honestly. But apparently today I'm lucky. Wow, this is too loud, a bit less. Okay. And I guess we can start moving. Why not? What can we wait for at this point? Should I take off straight from where I am? Yes. I see no problems with it. It's a fighter. It will take off in such a short space anyway. So I hope. Okay, Mr. 100%, enemy 100%. There's a bunker in front of me, so I best pull the stick. That's what happens when you don't turn from the runway, but like I said, it's a fighter, no problem like that. Okay, well, let's look for some Germans, I guess. Is the other base still under attack? No. Okay, this zoom in looks correct. This looks correct. This can look correct. It's a bit annoying because the APD is not perfect. But I would have to stand up, get the other keyboard. It's annoying. Let's keep it like this. Okay, open the radiator, starting to read the radio, of course. This is not War Thunder. You gotta consider the performance rating of your. Is inspired by Stalin. What is he saying? Polsky exit. For Stalin, great leader. For Stalin. I hate Nazis. I'm with Stalin. He's getting into his role playing. I follow comrade. Oh my god, these guys really live it in an intense way. For me, it's just fly the plane and have fun. Some others try to make it a bit more political, I guess. Okay, every game is like that. Taking off someone else. Oh, I'm still overheating. Open, open, radiator. Yeah. And let's all in the mixture a bit, I guess. Yes. Am I smoking? Still smoking? No smoke. Come on. You're no longer overheating. Well, it's still overheating, apparently. It is summer after all, huh? Open even more. The heck? Okay, it's gone. It is gone. Be gone. Smoke. Alright, I keep climbing. Yeah, against Germans, you gotta stay high. The sad truth is, even if you fight better at low altitude, if you find the German above you, well, it's already too late. He can dive and take you out in no time. The railway has been destroyed, and that is indeed good. Hey, thank you for the follow. Kevin, I love this game. I left it a bit, but now I come back to it and I might start playing it again frequently. Well, either this or War Thunder anyway. Now I don't want to say any sacrilege. I do enjoy both. I'm crazy like that. Okay. Perhaps I should try guarding a friendly objective. That would be easier. We are at cloud altitude at this point. Our railway station is under attack. Unfortunately, it's the other side of the map. Let me see who are the top players. I don't know these guys, no. Sado Frogu. It's the meme, the sad frog, no? But he's typing it in Japanese. Sado Frogu. Nuclear Man, Scam Rider. Ancient Giant, I love that name. Okay, I should check my six regularly to tell you the truth. I'm not yet in enemy territory, but it's a game where death comes very, very suddenly, unless you spot it in time. It's not easy to remember, but I will try. I will try. Okay, now heading straight for the factory and past the tractory, their train. I don't want to go above enemy jetties, but then again, I do carry rockets now that I remember it, eh? We could fire the rockets on the depots and then go to the factory. Just a pass, of course, and then accelerate away. I'm carrying six rockets, I mean. But I could use the rockets on a bomber if I spot one. We'll see, whatever happens first. Diving from this high in a Russian plane is never a good idea, though, eh? I would have to descend before approaching the factory. We'll see, we'll see. About. I think it's the 820 that took off with me. I think it's dark enough to look like an 820. Should we offer some escort? Maybe rocket away at the same target he attacks. I guess it could be interesting if I don't lose it. And apparently, I did lose it. Like I said, it is difficult to spot things in Stormwake, and even when you spot them, it's difficult not to lose them. You know how the game is. Okay, if it were the A20... Ooh, but I turned all the way around. When did I do it? So that's the reason I had the instinct to look behind. It seems strange, in fact, and I thought, why am I looking? Okay, but unfortunately my masked memory only worked to that extent. If he was heading for the depot, we will find him again. Of course, formation flying is difficult when it's just no communication. This game is often without communication, alas. Should be able to spot the depot. Is that a plan? Not sure. Oh yes, there's two of them. That's the A20. And these look like fighters. There's two big bombers there, above the enemy objective, but I don't think it's likely that they are enemies. If they were enemies, they would be 110s, but it doesn't seem likely. Okay, let's set to that objective and see what we can do. The most problematic thing is that I still don't see it. Depot. Depot is where the city is. I saw a city. Oh, they're bombing it. Okay, now we know where it is. Okay, let's drop these rockets. I mean, fire the rockets since they're not bombs. And then we resume surveillance for enemy planes. Anyway, they will attack the bomber first. I might be using him a bit as a bait. Is he bombing the other buildings? Can you see? There's not many left standing. Maybe I could attack these. Are they containers, I think? Okay, got these, but not these. I'll fire at these. I still had a couple of rockets, unfortunately. I released them because I didn't want to be heavy. I think I destroyed the containers, right? But now let's be on our toes for enemy fighters, because they certainly attracted their attention. Too bad that I still had two rockets, but I guess they were unneeded. Anyway, I'm not doing a second pass, I'm already too vulnerable for enemy tried one. As a fighter, I mean, especially above the enemy objective. Luckily, it doesn't have MTA. And I'm checking my score later. I best be very, very careful at this moment. See, I'm very careful, but at the same time I know that if a German comes down from the clouds, I'd be finished. Most of all, the most important rule in this game is always expect everyone to have a wingman. I died so many times. The moment they turn on their lights, the moment they seem to be stalling for time, expect them to be receiving reinforcements anytime. Never stay above the objective for too long. In fact, let's go away at this point. I guess it's time. Oh, here's the German. I don't think he's seen me, huh? He's probably diving for someone else. Okay. This looks enticing. I don't think he's seen me. Increase the power. Let's try to catch up. Of course, if the German keeps going in the same direction, he'll be way faster than me. But like I said, they expect everyone to have a minimum. And so, look every direction at the same time. Hey, I never catch up with a German flying level at high altitude. Unfortunately, that's not the way technology works in World War II. Here you have it. Honestly, guys, I don't know, but I'll follow. It is a fighter above the enemy objective, so it could be a fighter guarding it. I don't understand what she's doing, honestly. Crap, it disappeared. Unfortunately, the minimum level of zoom, honestly, is not usable. I gotta change the EPD. I tested it, but I didn't test it well, I guess. It makes me feel a certain headache. Come the second sortie, I'll have to reconfigure it. That's a bomb crater, very far from the objective, actually. Okay, here we have combat. That's a friend, I think. Strapping the target. I don't know what he expects to do. Or he could be chasing. He is chasing the German. Who is damaged? Is he going down? I don't think he is. No, he is. He is. Well, good kill, I guess. I arrived too low. Too late. Let's climb again. Also, I'm very visible now because I'm where they were fighting. He arrived too late. Too late. Okay, climbing. They get a target in the end. Yes. No. Yes. I destroyed something on the ground. Doesn't amount to much, but we are still flying, so never say never. The victory might arrive. Honestly, I would go guarding the factory, like I said. It's just better to stay above a friendly target as a fighter if you intend to get a kill. At least you might have anti-air cover. There might be other people that you can follow. Holy shit. Well, that's a friend, thankfully. Let's stay with him, I guess. Let's see what he's doing. He's going south. Well, if I can fly with someone else, I would stay here. Unfortunately, this is usually is the game of mute pilots. Normally, you would need to have the option to open a voice chat channel within, no? I guess it might be realistic to not have any form of communication in World War II air war, but between pilots who met at random, it just makes our life more difficult. And besides, no one would be using it because anyway, the game doesn't have voice chat at all. Many don't play it even with a microphone, if you can believe it. And you have the guys that fly information, and then you are screwed when you meet them, essentially. It's the guy flying an LA-5. He seems much faster than me. He's clearly guarding the target, yes. Okay, is he not ready? No, here it is. The feeling of scale for this game is compared to War Thunder on a totally different level. Like when you see the clouds and you see the ground, you can tell the distance between the two. In War Thunder, hey Pius, hello, Pius is here. So where are the tank battles? I guess they are below. They are below, Pius, we're flying. We are flying, I told you I wouldn't be playing War Thunder today. Pius, you gotta understand that I like many different types of games. If I did only War Thunder, I would be missing all the others. Tomorrow, well, maybe, I think tomorrow I might be unable to play, honestly. We'll see. I wanted to play this, yes. Because someone might join, or anyway, I wanted to play this. About what? Tomorrow? No. No, I might have something to do, honestly. If I have to speak honestly, I'm not sure I'll be playing tomorrow. Possibly. Not in the morning, anyway. Perhaps in the afternoon, this time. Let me see. Well, let's move to a friendly target at this point. I might find bombers, which are easier to spot and also kill. How's my fuel, by the way? I had got into the good habit of turning on the cockpit lights, so you can read them better. I don't even know if the Yak actually has a fuel indicator, to tell you the truth. I know how the fuel indicator for Russian planes is shaped, and I don't see it here. So, no, it doesn't have it. I think this is the plane, unless it's this, this looks very much like it, but it can't be fuel. I didn't even take off in full fuel. I think it's the one where the pegs on the wings actually go up when you have little fuel. But it will be a while. It will be a while before I actually run out of fuel. Let's go to the factory then. This game, hunting for targets, is half of the game, honestly. It happens so often that you just fly, fly, fly and never find anything coming your way. And it looks so damn good. It looks so damn good. Here you have them. Let me see. They're actually easy to spot because they're inside the cloud. I tend to maintain them more or less in front of me. That's not the factory, not where I was anyway, whatever it was, the depots. It's not the depots. Here they are. That looks big, it's a bomber. If it's a bomber that big, there's very high probability that it's German, because Russians don't have big bombers in this game. And that also looks German to me. That's not Russian plane, yeah. Increase speed. Come on, we might be there. That's not Russian plane, right? No, with the white stripe. That's German. Well, I hope that's German because I'm shooting him. Come on! That's German indeed. I don't know how we fucking miss it. Seems such a safe shot. Okay. But whether you're getting away or not, honestly, I don't know. Try to save one more. Already shot plant. He seems, well, he's smoking, but I think he's just overstressing the engine in the hopes of getting away. Let's try to get closer. Let's try to get closer. I already shot too much. Okay. We don't get any more German than that. Oh, goddamn. Did he just trick me? Why is everyone so good in this game? That would have worked in War Thunder. And also he's got a friend. Okay, I didn't think it went well. And it's a shame because I actually had the perfect opportunity and apparently I squandered it. And that goddamn shame. Here he is. Now I have got two of them on my tail, like I said. Assume everyone has a wingman. And assume his wingman to be ready to kick your ass. Okay, they cannot turn as well as me, of course, because I'm a Yak, whereas they are BFs. But there's just too many of them. I will make them waste some time on this before they get me. You cannot turn like a Yak. Just like I cannot go as fast as you. We're playing to the plane's strength, actually. Let's lower the flaps as well. Okay, this is not good. Did you just pass me on the left? Indeed. But it's too fast. Okay, it's going away. What about the other one? I think I have help, honestly. Everything can still happen. But the problem is there's at least two enemies on me. Okay, that one missed as well. But this one didn't miss. How many fucking enemies are shooting me at the moment? I'm wounded. The plane is damaged, the engine is. Did I hit anyone? Did I kill anyone even? I don't know, I have some points. No, I don't know. I don't know. I'm sure I hit at least a bit, but okay, I'm going to die at this point. Yes, I lost control. Boo! You fucker! Okay, we need to correct the EPD on the minimum level of zoom because it just doesn't work. So I need another keyboard, the keyboard which has the F keys. And most of all, I need to remember how it's done, but I should be able to do it quickly enough. Okay, let's see what happened with this sortie. Surprising that I didn't hit that guy. He was flying straight and level. Maybe I fired too soon. Only the building. That's quite disappointing. Okay, this time I spawn here. And we're out of MiG-3s. It's okay. LAG-3 sounds good to me. Without modification. I don't know, what modification can I put? Ah, the 23 mm gun. They told me it's good. Okay, and go. And go and spawn. Ooh, I fired. Okay. Well, if I fired, I'll have to respawn. But most of all, I need to correct this. It seems okay. It's almost okay, but it isn't. Okay, if I well remember, it's Shift F9. No, that's not the quick view. Wait. Okay. No, it's just Alt F9. No, and this center the quick view again. Shift F10. God damn it, I did it so many times. No, no, CTRL, no. I'm trying everything now. Quick view save. Perfect, we completely screwed the quick view. How do I put it back? It's F10, I think. Oh, quick view saved. Well, but it's not good. F10. Yes. Okay, but the EPD problem is not solved. The EPD problem. I remember it was Alt F9. Maybe the other Alt. Here it is. Okay, to set this thing, EPD convergence, you shift page down, shift end. Yes. It's like going to an optician and getting a new pair of glass. It appears to be good. F12. To start it and let's turn on our engine. It's about that time. Because I used the other headset, you see? The other headset that basically had a different EPD. And for this zooming mode, you gotta set it manually. Okay, the engine is starting. Yes. So I didn't get a plane. Well, that's surprising. I was sure I got that plane. Yeah, it's the 2 points and the building, that's all. The centering seems to be pretty good, yeah. And then this. The lag actually has a fuel indicator, you see? I think I gotta turn left to be sure no, I'm not hitting something. Unlike I risked before at my first sortie. You basically have one chance to get a kill before his wingman, or wingmans, even plural, will get on you in like a sec. It almost doesn't matter how good you are. You still need cooperation to succeed in this game, which of course creates another set of pretty annoying problems. Look, this is better. Instead of having just a bunker in front of me, now I have an entire block of destroyed buildings. I hope I cleared them. Okay, I did. In fact, that's a big improvement, isn't it? That's a big improvement right there. Okay, let's head straight for the friendly target and hope this time I can have faith in friendlies. Yes, this is a good EPG setting. Doesn't create as many problems. To my headache. Take care of your eyes and they will take care of you. This is true in life just as in VR, but in VR even more so. Or your flying sessions will last very little. Until you understand how to set up everything correctly with these things, it's annoying. Unfortunately, some people never get past the phase. It's the reason VR is so unpopular. People say, ah, but this hurts my eyes, it makes me develop terrible headaches and conditions of all types. So, yeah, of course it does, if you don't set it up correctly. And another thing, you always have to keep an eye on the PC's performance. If the game runs bad, it's just bad too for your nausea and sickness and all that. First engine over it, open the radiator. Lower the RPM, lower the mixture, and... We're up. Come on. It's just hot. It's hot. It's summer. I'm smoking like a chimney at the moment. Okay, starting to cool off. But as I get higher, I will rape you, Dennis. Not that I am gay, but to humiliate you and make you. What the fuck are people writing in this game chat? I swear, people must be half crazy in multiplayer gaming. Scottless, no, he's on the server. I know him. So I didn't get the kill in the end, huh? That's annoying. I'm sure I hit him. But apparently, not enough. I was a bit too impatient. I should have waited more before shooting. This thing is annoying. Hey, hello, Ibrahim. Welcome back. Today it's the other flying game. This is Sturmovik. Why don't we kick Dennis? He left, lol. Cause the boat kick system is stupid, says that guy. They're arguing in chat. That's the good thing of having more players. Of course, there will be some troublemaker among them. Hey, Ibrahim, yeah. Do you want to play? Do you have this game? If you want, I'm in the same Discord. Ah, but it's late night, or early morning, I think, in your country now, so it would be problematic for you. But even without voice chat, it's a pretty good game. Maybe you can show me a trick or two. You seem skilled when we play War Thunder. Peeled, but most of all on the swivel for any plane to enter my field of view. We gotta get the kill. We gotta get the kill, otherwise it's wasted. Can I get the Discord server? Of course, of course, of course. I'll send you the Discord server. Wait, huh? You're on Facebook. This makes it a bit more difficult. How can I give you the Discord server in a quick way? I'm not so far from the objective. Well, we'll have to risk it, I guess. After all, many times in this game nothing happens for long stretches of time, no? Famous last words. let's try, I'll give you the Discord server. Wait, I turn away from the objective and activate the flying straight mode. It's worth it. If it's to play together, it is worth it. Discord. Create an invite, copy the link, and then go to Facebook Zarlok Gaming, and then hurry up, we're fighting a war here. Here it is. Where is the mouse pointer? Oh, where is that? On the other monitor. Okay, disregard the fact that you will hear two voices, but apparently you're not. Perfect. There you go. Okay. You have it, no? I think. Hope. Okay. What happened? The task is completed. The task is completed. That's good. Okay, factory. Let me know if you cannot join, but I think you should be able. Alright. Come whenever you feel like. Come especially if you want to play with me. That would be cool. That's the target? Like we're supposed. No, it's a factory, it's not an airfield. Let's go to this factory. Come on, come on. Hey, thank you for the follow, Luis. Welcome to the stream. We love flying ants on this page. We play flying ants all the time. The enemy attacked by railway train. Okay. He's attacked. The enemy is attacked by railway train. That's a weird way to put it. I could read into it that maybe the NTL of the train area is attacking 0927. 0927. No, it's okay, it's that, but 27. There is no train in 0927, there is one in 0925. Well, if I were the enemy, honestly, I would attack the factory, yes, not the train. But then again, everything is possible. Ah, here it is, that's the factory. Seems to be fully standing. And what's that? Someone else guarding it, but you never know. You never know. We best check. Double, triple, quadruple check, even. The sun in my eyes is never good. Oh, that's interesting. I will say no more. Let me look at it. Was smoking pretty hard. No, no longer smoking. No, no, it is. It's only not visible. No, wait a second. I'm looking at two different things. Well, okay. Once again, I'm lower than him. And once again, there is two. He's coming from friendly territory. I think it's a friend, but you never know. Yeah, that's Russian. Okay. I'm flying formation, I guess. I think he's escorting the bomber. The thing that was mocking Earth was probably an A-20 there. Where is it? Oh, I hope I don't scare him. Wait, I shouldn't place myself at people's seats. That's the factory, okay. Let's guard the factory together with him. Glory might come our way, maybe. I lost sight on the bomber, unfortunately. So close to getting that kill. Well. We can still maybe hope for the best. The server doesn't get any more full than this, after all. Okay, we are now exactly above the objective. This is a bit of a too much predictable way to defend it, I presume. But then again, it's also the most effective way. And also, there's people flying low on the objective. They might be enemy bombers. Let me see. If I were flying something that attacked that objective, I would be flying just like these guys. No, wait a sec. No, no, no. But I saw where the small tracks, so there are no flying islands at the moment. No. I wished it to be the enemy, but there is none. Okay. Let's go toward the enemy base, where they would come from to attack this, no? To say the truth, there is nothing on the market like this game, no? The way You have so long to wait before the action comes. Let it's so tense at all times. Holy shit. Okay, that's an I-16. Even picked a red one. We got a fancy guy here. Who's this guy? I might know him. Let me see who is in the chat. Nice red I-16. Let's see if he responds. Okay. He clearly came close to me to be looked at. Okay, the chemo the alley countries fulfill the target. No, this is good. Look at this. We just won. He's not responding, no. Not responding. Well, okay. Probably wasn't paying attention to the chat then. We won. Okay, didn't do much. Well, I did destroy one ground target, I guess. Yes, it's an interesting online game, you're right. Obrahim, nothing like it. Ideally, you will play it with friend. But it's cool alone as well. Okay, look at that, it's the I-16. That's not the same thing I was looking at before. Is it the factory? Yeah. I might have mistook the factory for something else the entire time. Well, anyway. No, it's impossible. Maybe it just looks different at a distance. It's so recognizable. No, the fact is, it looks undamaged from this distance. It only shows the damage when you get right. When you get right over it. We still might find a target before the round ends. I think after this we fly the bomber to an objective, then we resume our fighter duty. We better do one each. We do fighter bomber. Took the fighter again because it annoyed me that I couldn't get the kill, but also I was thinking mostly at centering the EPD at that time. And by the way, I centered it properly, yes, this is perfectly good. But one curiosity, but do you see the circle when I zoom? Yeah, it's curious because you see it off center. Very weird. I think it's rendering only the right eye for you. Possibly. How bizarre. Hey, thank you for the follow. Moon, welcome to the stream. We didn't know one another, of course. It's the first time you come to my page. Thank you for following. This is an extremely cool game. Difficult to play, but from time to time it's good. Maybe playing it every day is a bit stressful, but once in a while it's really perfect. Okay, guys, we spotted something. Looks big. What's this? The factory. Oh, it's an entire enemy formation. Thank you for the like as well. Okay, they're attacking the objective at the very last moment. That is an ally. This looks like white tracers. This looks German. This looks German. Let's go for him. He's already damaged. I might deliver the final blow. Yes, it's German. There's also another Russian firing at him. I think he might be the same guy that killed me earlier because he's using a brown camo. That's uncommon. After all, we didn't meet him in the same place. But I missed. Okay, don't black out. Don't black out. Well, anyway, he certainly cannot accelerate after me. This time I have the speed advantage and he also got many people on his tail. Anyway, let's still go for him, no? I might get lucky. You see when you have the speed advantage. No, end of mission! No, end of mission! Don't end the mission now! God damn it! To end the mission now is cruel. It's just cruel. It's cruel. God damn it. Finally found some action, and some cool action to boot. Well, okay, I guess we destroyed some containers with rockets. Better than nothing. Better than nothing indeed. Guys, I'm thirsty. I'm thirsty. It's hot in real life, not only in the game. It's starting to get hot in Italy. Let me tell the temperature. We have 27 degrees. Now it might not seem much. That happened. It's not giving me a camera view again. Here you have it. 27 degrees. And for VR, it's plenty. Ok. Back to the driving seat, which is also the piloting seat, and well, it's the seat in general, the seat from where I shoot the pew-pew. Ok. It's loading. I hope it doesn't hang up. No, but it does like this. It's normal. It's just a game that takes some time to boot. Yeah, you like the room. Cool, huh? I can actually go VR camera and show you. It's like you see the real world from VR. Isn't that cool? Here you have it. I sit here with the keyboard in front, wheel, and that's the monitor. Cable hanging from the ceiling, of course. Ideal solution. So, what are we waiting for? I hope the game hasn't crashed. No, I don't think it has. No, it's loading. It's loading. I can even show you the room in another way. This is pretty cool, huh? Watch this. You can actually have an overlay on top of the game. I love it. I love it. I gotta do it from time to time just because I love it. With the borders, you turn on the camera like this, and this even works with the game. So you see, basically, now there is no game because it's loading. But you have an overlay of real life on top of the game. Ain't that cool? Yeah, it's the camera that the Index has. It's got two cameras here. If I cover the camera, it goes away. It's my hands, only in 3D. What are we freaking waiting for? No, it's loading. It's not stuck yet. I know it's loading. I trust the game like that. Go! I don't know what we are waiting for at this point. Mr. Moik is weird. Loading. Oh, there you are. There you are. There you are. Come on, I want to spawn a bomber and I want to be quick about it. I stick to the Russian side. I like Russian side after all. Come on, hurry up, game. Load up. This server is weird. I guess other people are also having trouble. Not just me. Okay, Russian. From the ribs. Let me see. Ooh, this is a lighter war scenario. No, from Ask, and I go to the fortified area. There's no bomber here. Is there a bomber here? There's no bomber here either. I gotta go all the way from here. There's no bomber whatsoever. Excuse me. What the fuck? We don't have a bomber in this scenario. Only fighters. No? This is rare, guys. Wings of Liberty is now running modern, more late war planes. I never flew the Tempest on this server. Ah, yes, the A20. Well, we laugh funnier. I fly the A20 because I said I want to go bomber, but then I'll go absolutely Tempest. I love that thing. Okay, 60% with 16 bombs and Bendix Compass that I won't use, but anyway. So, we got the late war planes today. That's pretty cool, guys. On Wings of Liberty, they finally figured it out that they should have a variety of scenarios, not only the same things again and again. Okay, let's start this plane already. The sooner the better. We want to arrive on the objectives before the enemy. Some other guy who had the same idea as me. I see a Spitfire. That's a Spitfire, isn't it? It's the Russian Spitfire, I think. Oh, sure. Damn, I still suck at identifying fighters. Okay, so exactly where I am, by the way. Ah, the rifts. Okay, we hit the train, I guess. Okay. This breaks by usage of the differential pedals, yes. That guy was heavier than me. Will do like he does. He's standing left, yes. Look how much smoke comes out of the A20. It's crazy. One engine is running. Well, whether it's the Spitfire or not, it certainly is a spitting fire, as you may notice. Come on. So slow. Oh. There's plenty of people that go A20 at the beginning of the round. I hope you see me. Okay, let me pass. Lower the flaps. Maximum mixture, maximum travel. Go! Combat mode. No, even emergency mode. And rolling. The sound is amazing. You don't have this kind of sound in War Thunder. Oh, come on. 150. Ah, it's miles, right. It seems so slow because it's miles. American plane. I was miles ahead compared to what I thought. Unfortunately, I gotta turn the other way. Okay, retracting the flaps. Check coal flats. All right, close the coal flats. Took! Otherwise, it's shaking, shaking. And we turn to the train. And what was the button? Okay, to look behind. But I think in this summer scenario, we gotta reduce the mixture quite a bit, or I smoke like a factory. I will be the factory that the enemy needs to bomb, basically. You gotta fly a big plane after flying a small plane, and then you will fly a big plane again, and so on. It's a cycle. Some big city. Ah, we're flying. This is also the Bodenplatte map, of course. I think. Yes, I think we are in Germany. Or is it Belgium? Not sure. Well, the names of the airfield sounds German. Interesting lighting effect on the aiming sight, so greenish tinted. You know about the A20? This is a rather powerful ground attack plane. It carries an hefty load of bombs and has a front-facing armament that is not too bad. In fact, it is possible to get air kills with the A20 and not just by means of the rear turrets. Okay, we shall be attacking a train. Unless the other A20 gets to it before me. Unfortunately, I lost sight of him. Maybe I should spot him again because he was going the same place. 100%. Sometimes you got a spot in between the cockpit and the chat overlay, yes. It's part of the experience, of course. So, how is this train situated indeed? Past the city of Errai, city of Gelden, to the north of the city, which is the left, along the tracks. Well, it would be along the tracks. This is the first city. The second city is smaller. It's too early to spot it. Let's climb a bit more. I think it will be safer. Strange that I don't see it yet. Well, anyway, the river is there. Well, it's Winds of Liberty. I know always where I am. Hi, Chris. Thank you for liking the stream. O sei italiano? Credo che cognome suona italiano. Benvenuto in ogni caso. Okay. Panda, you try P38 as fighter? Let's go, the red panda says. Okay. Let me see, guys. Oh, here's the other city. And the bombing target is very slightly to the left, more or less in front where I'm looking. That looks like a bridge. So convenient, in a bomber you can just press Svizzero. Ah, Switzerland. So I presume you speak both English and Italian. Sei anche tu un giocatore di flight simulators? No, lo chiedo perché cerco sempre qualcuno con cui cooperare nel mio stream. Questi sono giochi che sono molto meglio con un Wingman, ovviamente. Ok. That could be the station, honestly. It looks more like a bridge, though. Is the station supposed to be close to a bridge? I think so. No, wait a sec. The river runs too close to the city. The station is farther to the left. So, if that is the river, that cannot be the river. That's another river. Right above the big river, but we don't care about that. That's Wheezy. Wiz, however it's pronounced. Con la scuola di Web Project Management devo fare una presentazione sulla VR, quindi mi sto un po' informando, ma che cosa molto molto interessante. Per i progetti web, mi dici, no? Le potenzialità sono enormi, per me è il futuro, sotto tutti i punti di vista. E questa è anche l'importanza dei videogiochi, perché finché questi dispositivi non sono in tutte le case, in quanto gente se li compra per i videogame, sarà sempre problematico poter costruire qualsiasi tipo di discorso aziendale incentrato su questo. Ma il futuro è interessante, perché comunque sia qualcosa si muove ogni giorno un po' di più. E beh, sono qui per fare la mia parte. Io credo fermamente nella realtà virtuale, da grande appassionato di videogames e non solo. Comunque, bello, bello. Ottima cosa. Che sia già materia di studio, intendo, no? I think we're almost at the objective. The train is straight in front of me. L'Oculus Quest, bello. Praticamente lo puoi usare anche per i giochi su PC, lo sai, no? Sicuramente lo saprai, devi prendere un cavo extra, ma chiaramente il bello di quello è l'indipendenza dai cavi, ovviamente. Io non l'ho ancora preso perché amo questo tipo di giochi, ovviamente lì non ce ne sono molti. Non è fatto per questi, è fatto per un altro tipo di giochi. Guys, I cannot see the freaking target. It's right past the road. It's not a river, it's a road. That's a bridge, was meaning I don't understand. That's the railway. Ok, now see the railway. I'm opening the bomb bay, but I still don't see the target. That's unprecedented. Ah, because the target is not a train station, it's a train. Meaning that it moves. Ecco perché non lo vedo. È un treno, quello se n'è andato. Oh! Io ho il Mac. Ah, ok, quindi praticamente tieni il gioco separato dal computer di lavoro. This is the railway, isn't it? Yeah. Alas, I see no train. Now, which way could the train be heading? That's a tough question, I presume. Let me climb again before someone spots me, and in the meantime take a good look at the map. You know what I would do? I would go straight to the industrial area. At least it doesn't move. You can't move an industrial area. So let's overfly the city and go to the industrial area while hoping that no enemy fighter did the same mistake as me. Unless I see the train, of course. That's not the. No, that's not the railway. The railway is not the one with the bridge, I presume. It's this other grayish thing. I should have read the briefing, I guess. That's always a good practice, yeah. Quel MacBook Pro, so che c'è chi ha provato, ma non voglio complicarmi la vita. Beh, certo, però considera che sono bei giochi, eh.
Sono bei giochi, al di là di questo, vabbè, chiaramente ti devono piacere i simulatori di volo, però ci sono anche delle cose che meritano per tutti. Uno di questi ovviamente è Half-Life Alyx, che personalmente io non ho amato molto come gioco, ma è una demo tecnica fuori di questo mondo, perché comunque la grafica è fantastica, comunque riprende una serie molto popolare. What's happening, guys? I got a gunner at the moment. The gunner is becoming operative. I don't like it, it means an enemy is in the area. This might end badly. Let me see, I'm smoking just a bit, I don't think the A10 can smoke less than this. Meritano, sì, perché comunque alla fine l'Oculus Quest sono giochi necessariamente semplici, perché per quanto tu puoi avere un processore che comunque sì, è raffreddato, a differenza di quello di un cellulare è bello pompato, però comunque è un dispositivo che è grande come un cellulare, quindi più di tanto. Purtroppo io non credo che ci libereremo del filo tanto presto per quanto concerne la realtà virtuale, perché la potenza di carico che richiede, la potenza di calcolo che richiede è semplicemente troppo elevata. Ci vuole un PC esterno che te la genera. È interessante il discorso wireless. Quello andrebbe esplorato. Wireless col computer, quindi sì, ho detto non ci libereremo del filo, dovrei dire non ci libereremo del PC. Ma con un PC collegato in wireless potrebbe forse funzionare. Comunque il Quest prima o poi me lo prendo. Forse lo prenderei pure adesso, però girano queste voci che potrebbe uscire la versione nuova l'anno prossimo, non lo so. Ero curioso di vedere, perché comunque sulla realtà virtuale fissa, tra la prima e la seconda generazione, considerando l'Oculus Rift la prima, questo index è infinitamente superiore, c'è una differenza enorme. Ok, that's the industrial area, guys. I think there's no way of mistaking it for something else. It looks very industrial. And I still see no enemy fighter. Wait a sec. Well, whatever it is, it's far. Whatever it is, it's far. Let's ignore him for the time being. And go straight for the industrial area. The industrial area, where the river does the C shape. Ok. What is that? How can it not be that? It's the industrial area of Wesel, southern part of the city, no, western part of the city. It's that, I will come at it from the left. Let's hope a fire doesn't engage now. Trovo un tizio su eBay che lo vendeva nuovo a 100 che sono quelle sterline, sì. L'ho preso al volo, ah beh, 100 sterline, wow. L'Oculus Quest 106, ha fatto un affare incredibile, l'avrei preso pure io. E beh. Mica male, complimenti. Ok. I see no evil, I am the evil. When you see no evil, it means you are the evil. I am the guy that is going to bomb the city and that's killing many innocent civilians, I guess. That is also war, isn't it? Hey, Mohamed, thank you for following the stream and welcome to my page. We play a lot of simulators, not just flights. Also driving. This morning I had quite some fun with rallying. Okay, well, it's an enormous target. There's so many high value buildings here. We're going to score big. I hope no one pounces on me now. Okay, that's just anti-air. Hurry, hurry now. You can get attacked at any time. I see anti-air, that's also dangerous. Let's try to fly in a bit more unpredictable way. God, if they shoot me down now, it will be horrible. Should I strike that stupid? Guys, this is dangerous. Yes. Because I'm the first one on the target, but that means I score more. Let's do it, guys! Let's bomb away! Bomb, bomb, bomb! I got so many bombs. Bomb, bomb, bomb! And yeah! We took out so many buildings, yeah! Too bad the explosions didn't show. Now we gotta land this, absolutely. Roll trimmer rods jammed. What is this? Bomb doors closed. Okay. Now, if I don't return to base and get full points for this, spero che non ci sia una fregatura. Ah, ma perché non ce l'hai ancora? Ti deve arrivare. Beh, speriamo di no, certo. Sarebbe un peccato. Oddio, penso che eBay in quel caso qualche protezione data. I hear some strange sound. Was I damaged? No. I think I jammed something after doing that very tight turn. It was maybe too tight for the airplane. Ok, let me see how many points I score. I destroyed 7 buildings and 2 planes, packet planes even. There were packet planes in the industrial area. Why? 30 giorni di tempo, ok, l'hai ordinato ieri. No, eBay è abbastanza sicuro, sì. Onestamente non ci ho mai comprato tanto. Ma forse ho preso più sole con Amazon che con eBay, paradossalmente. È vero che pure Amazon ti copre sempre. Comunque sarà un bel colpo soprattutto riuscire a trovarlo, perché oggi come oggi questi dispositivi sono praticamente introvabili, tanto non lo capiscono che il mercato c'è e ancora ne producono pochi, poi capirai adesso con la pandemia, praticamente qualsiasi cosa è introvabile, si ha a che vedere con la realtà virtuale, ma c'è l'antiaerea pure in mezzo ai campi. Why am I being shot at by anti-air? I'm far away from the objective, no? Guys, we gotta land it properly, this is worth a lot of points. Hi Harsh! Hey, welcome back. We just bombed the enemy city. Look at that. I razed the enemy industrial complex. If I can land this mission, I get so many points. So many. And then we fly the Tempest, which is a very cool aircraft. Sono andato sul sito di Oculus e non sono più disponibile, infatti. Sì, è bellissimo, c'è scritto. Ah, abbiamo la realtà virtuale per tutti. E poi ci sono i tre modelli. E poi non disponibile, non disponibile, non disponibile. Perfetto. L'index è introvabile da mesi. Penso che ormai addirittura pure quelli dell'HTC siano esauriti, che nessuno voleva. Niente, non li fanno, non capiscono che la richiesta c'è. Il futuro è questo, la gente l'ha capito, eppure non l'hanno capito le aziende. Ma non l'hanno capito neanche le aziende che fanno i giochi, eh. Infatti, meno male che ci sono i simulatori, perché se no di cose che veramente puoi giocare a oltranza non c'è molto nel mondo della realtà virtuale. So più o meno, sono sempre quelli. Eh sì, vedo che sei d'accordo. Ok. Guys, this time I play this map on Wings, says Beetlejuice. In fact, it is, yeah. They never play the late war scenario. Attention, the enemy attacked the northern group of troops. Cover required. We will be offering the cover soon enough. Come on, I got closer to two air kills, so it doesn't take so much longer for me to achieve one. Qui in Ticino hanno aperto 2 centri per il VR. Ah, lo so, no. In Italia non credo che ne abbiamo, comunque non ci sono mai stato. Il problema è che non so quanto in una breve esperienza uno riesce a capire, perché comunque all'inizio ti devi abituare, no? Se tu non l'hai mai fatta, vedrai. Ma forse l'hai fatto perché ci sono questi centri per la guerra. Io almeno parlando per me, all'inizio ho avuto qualche problema ad adattarmi. Ti sembra di non vedere bene, no? Ti sembra sempre sfocato perché comunque te lo devi sistemare bene, devi fare. Però poi una volta che allora. Ma domanda, visto che mi sembri bello preso, quanto riesci a restare connesso? Ah, in realtà virtuale? Ma io non ho dei medi ormai. Dipende anche dal gioco, eh? Però tranquillo anche 3-4 ore di seguito, nessun problema. Con questo, con l'index lo puoi fare. Forse con l'Oculus no. Poi dipende anche dal gioco. Ci sono giochi in cui fai tanti movimenti rapidi che sono imprevedibili, e allora ti può far venire mal di mare. Però quando guidi un veicolo che comunque c'è riferimento fisso della cabina del veicolo e tutto questo, non hai problemi. A me non mi fa più niente, però è pure importante una cosa. Vabbè, tu col Quest non ce l'avrai questo problema, ma con i giochi su PC devi controllare sempre la prestazione. Infatti, io qui giù ho un diagnostico. Si vede se guardo così, eccolo qui. Se scendi sotto i 40 frame al secondo, e purtroppo qui ogni tanto ci scendi perché con questo gioco non ce la fai a non scendere, rischi di avere mal di mare. È importante saperlo. È importante saperlo. Hai provato quello della PlayStation e poi altri negli. Purtroppo non si vede perché sto programma è stupido, non me lo fa vedere. Aspetta. Dove stai? Beh, non c'è. Non lo so che ho fatto. Vabbè, lo leggo dopo, non vorrei fare casini adesso. È un peccato perché la missione è andata bene. Non riesco a vedere la fine del messaggio. Quando scrivi qualcos'altro lo vedo. Purtroppo OBS, comunque avevi detto che l'hai provato nelle sale giochi. Ok, quindi sai di che si parla. No, è bello, comunque è bello. Non c'è niente di comparabile dal punto di vista dei videogame. Negli anni, ok, negli anni, grazie. No, grazie, volevo scorrerlo manualmente, ma tanto poi lo rifà. Purtroppo è fatto così. E non è che poi c'hai tante alternative, perché in realtà virtuale puoi mettere in overlay il secondo monitor, sì, ma se ci apri 45 finestre poi. La prima volta 20 anni fa a Berlino, ah, la prima volta pure la mia fu tanto tempo fa. Io penso feci. C'era una fiera, ero un bambino praticamente. Saranno stati fine anni 90. Oh crap, someone is attacking me. Fecero una fiera qui a Roma, all'Ergaif, l'Ergaif Hotel, famoso luogo di fiere. E beh, la provai lì. C'era il gioco degli pterodattili. Guys, what's happening? I lost control. But why? Not seem to be so damaged. I think he attacked me somehow. I don't understand. What got damaged so badly, but I'm going down. Yeah. It's a shame, it's a shame, it's a shame. I was so close to returning. We still get plenty of points. I'd like to jump on here too and play with you next week. Sometime when you're playing. I've got Oculus Rift S. Ah, really, Ashmer? You're welcome. Anytime. Anytime. I'm always looking for Wingman. Either this or War Thunder if you like that too. Whatever you prefer. Just let me know and we can organize it. Ok. Well. I still got 18 points. It's a shame because this would have been more than 100 points. It would have been 100 points. But I guess we can take the Tempest now, so it's a mixed blessing. I just didn't see the enemy. Sometimes it can happen in this game. Should I carry bombs? No, I already did the bomb roll. Let's just be a Tempest, and it's the coolest plane of the game. You gotta be careful because it's easy to. Deliveries are almost the same. Take the ones with some stripes. You gotta like them stripes. The problem with this plane, it's very fast and maneuverable, which is a deadly combination in a game where G-forces are modeled correctly, like this is. Look at the Mustang. And yeah, it's very easy to black out. Too bad I lost these points. These were crazy amount of points. Look at that, I'm first even without landing it. But that guy really ruined my score. Ok, let's do it guys, time to go back to fighter. Io scappo, ok, ciao Chris, grazie per aver partecipato allo stream. E vedrai che hai fatto un ottimo acquisto, ne sono certo. Ci vediamo. Fighter time, let's go. I don't think I have a mixture. No, actually I have a mixture control on this plane. The radiator is either completely closed or completely open. It's kind of weird, really. It's a Tempest thing. I think it should stay open in this weather. Bye bye. Did I close the canopy? Yeah. This is a crazy powerful plane. It's got an engine that is scary. It can reach the stratosphere in no time and also turns almost like a Spitfire. It looks similar too. Okay, why is not moving? I don't know honestly, it should move. Yeah. Easy now, don't overdo it. Strange, it's got some difficulty accelerating. Maybe the grass is too tall. Oh, this does the same thing as the Spitfire. It loves to spin. I broke it. Oh, you know, I'm thinking now, I don't know how often I took off with this plane in multiplayer, honestly. Okay, I gotta try again. It's unfortunate, but. So it's like the Spitfire, it's hard to take off. You gotta accelerate gradually. I should have expected it, to tell you the truth. Okay, let's have another go at it. Ah, there's another one. I might follow him. Let's see what he does. I'll do the same thing as him. He might know the plane better than me. You know when he moves like that in the beginning? There's supposed to be a person that is actually spinning the propeller by hand to start the engine. I hear the anti-air is actually firing, eh? This airfield is very much under attack at the moment. Okay, I will be extra careful this time. Like that guy, basically. Don't overdo it. It's a light and powerful plane. Priming cylinders with fuel. Takes his damn time to start, huh? Okay, we started more or less at the same time. I guess I'll let him go first. I want to see how he does it. Let me check that he's moving. This doesn't have a differential break, no. Well, it has it, but it's automatic. Okay, it seems to be having trouble even more than me. So disregard the idea, because yes, he's not keeping control of the plane, unless he has a precise idea. Ooh, he's carrying the bombs as well. He's going to the right. Well, I said I would do like him, but in my opinion, he's going the wrong way. So, never mind. Let's accelerate slowly this time. Wow. Yeah, I lost to spin. It's a dangerous plane to take off in, I guess. Let's try to go very straight, as much as I can, and most of all, not to slow down too fast. You know how it works. If you slow down suddenly, you just worsen the spin in a plane. So that's what usually destroys your propeller, like I did. But okay, as you can see, it takes off in no time. With the power it has, it would. Okay. Of course, the view is not center. No, okay, okay, in fact it is. More or less, I would unzoom it on a fighter, honestly. Oh, but not this much. More or less. The base is under attack and being bombed, if you can believe it. So, let's turn again for the base and see what's happening. Yes, anti-air is firing. And yes, that might be the enemy. Let's open the radiator, because I'm going fast now. Let's see if we have a Kira coming our way. I'm not sure, it could just be a friend that just took off. In fact, it doesn't look particularly German to me. I think it's just the Mustang from before. But the base is still under attack, yeah? Well, I'm following him, but I think it's just the Mustang. Ah, I love this rear visibility. Hey, thank you for the like. Fabio, welcome to the stream. No, this is just a friend. Okay, well, I'll go with him. Is the base still under attack? No, in fact, he probably was shot down. It's not worth pursuing. They are taking off too. Let's go with the Mustang. Let's go with the Mustang. I think I can keep up with that Tempest. And it's a follow as well from Fabio. Hey, welcome. Thank you. You're very welcome on my page. We play a lot of flight simulators, but not only that. Also driving and sometimes other types of VR games. Now moving to the enemy. I had a wonderful ground attack sortie where I destroyed a lot of targets. But unfortunately got shot down on my way back. I was flying an A-20, so now I switched to a fighter to achieve some revenge. This is the Tempest. The Hawker Tempest is a late war British plane. Basically a Spitfire on steroids. Incredibly powerful. And also quite nimble. So in fact it's dangerous for the pilot itself, because if you pull the stick too much, in no time you will black out and kill yourself, so we gotta be extremely careful with that. But I can win most dogfights if I spot the enemy in time. The base is again once again under attack and not returning all the way there. But it's interesting news nonetheless. It appears that I'm producing a bit too much smoke, reduce the mixture. Also because there's not much you can do with the radiator in this plane. You can only open or close it, and the moment it's open. So if you want to reduce the smoking, I guess it's either reduce RPM, and I will, or mixture, and I just did, and what else can I do? But maybe it just produces smoke. Could be that it's a smoky airplane. It's not the type of thick smoke that implies trouble with the engine, it's just a smoke. It's a shame though, because it makes me easier to spot. Let me try to reduce the mixture but increase the RPM. There must be a trick to it. That's not bad. It stopped. Maybe it's the temperature, huh? Because I'm climbing more and so it's keeping itself cooler. I think. Okay, that's definitely a contact above the railroad station, which is a friendly objective, so it could be there. Let's keep an eye on the mission chat. If it tells me that the... What's that? The railroad station is under attack, we know for sure. And the railroad station is inside of the city, I presume? Yes, inside of it. So let's use the city as reference and try to spot him again. Here you have it. Well, it seems to be just overflying the target, probably a friendly guarding it. But now he's diving, for whatever reason. If he's attacking, he's an enemy. If he's a friend, he's attacking an enemy. Anyway, that looks interesting. Yeah, now find him again. God damn it, this game is difficult. Okay, he's flashing his lights. Or is it someone on fire? Someone is flashing lights to ask for help from his wingman. Wait, wait, I don't want to enter the fray before I have a clear idea. You see how easy it is to black out? When I dive, I gotta keep it in mind, absolutely. Or I will die. It happened to me so many times. British planes are especially bad for it. They're so maneuverable. So much more maneuverable than what the pilot can tell. Okay. That's either a guy that has been shot down or the objective is under attack. Either case, we'll soon meet trouble, which is good, that's what we came here for after all. Okay, here you are. That looks... I don't know, looks German to me. Watch out, remember not to pull the stick too much. Okay, look at that, that's even more interesting. We are in an Oker Tempest, we can climb like crazy. Climb, climb. I don't want to go down if there are people up. I just expose myself too much. Look at the power of this plane's engine. I catch up in no time. No time whatsoever. Okay, that's combat. I think that's the German. Watch out, don't black out, easy now. The German is chased by two guys, I think. Low altitude now. If I pull the stick now, I black out. So don't pull it, only very, very easy. Okay. I think he got him. No, no, still flying. Coming very fast now. Look at them, that's a very heated duel. I can spot them without the zoom now. Too bad I'm not sure about which is the German. I think it's him. Yeah, he's also dead. No, no. Ha! I could almost steal the kill. Almost. But he will get him, I think. Unless he's German, but I don't think he is. No, no, it's like me. I hope he gets the right idea here. Oh shit, that's German. Holy heck, crap. I'm wounded. How's the plane? The plane is badly damaged. No, it's gone badly again. I think, I mean, if I'm still flying, there is hope. That's a Tempest. That's a German. Ah! The engine is damaged, but I'm still flying. But this was pretty cool anyway, even if it will end badly. And now the engine is starting to lose oil. Hey, hi Mitsuto! Welcome to the stream. Are you tagging a friend? I'm not sure. Welcome, welcome. Thanks for your comment anyway. I think I won't be in the air for much longer, honestly. You think that's German? I'm not sure. I cannot see very well because I'm freaking dying at the moment. I don't know, guys. That looks German. Looks like a Focke-Wulf. The shape of it is unmistakable. I don't think I hit him. Well, then again, he's smoking, yeah? That is German. Increase the speed anyway, we won't live much longer. We might as well try to bring someone with us to the afterlife. Okay. He's falling, look at this. I think I got a kill. I think I did. Have I? Yeah, I destroyed a guy, look at that. When you least expect it. But I will also die. Yes, I will also die. At least I destroyed a guy. Oh, I will die. But I brought a guy with me. Ooh, he crashed with me. I actually got 2 kills then. I got 2 kills because the guy crashed into me. So it's 2 kills. Guys, I love the Tempest. Let's fight the Tempest again. This is the best fighter. I love it. I love it. Yes, same place, same plane. Tempest. I got a kill anyway, so it's not bad. And the other guy crashed into me. It's cool, it's cool. We can still do good. What time is it? We still have a 1 hour. We certainly can do good. The truth of the matter is that it's so warm. Look what the fuck is happening. All this lightning. Everyone flying the lightning because finally they can use them. They can never use them. So, how's the score? 20 points. With 3 planes destroyed, but 2 were just parked. I don't know why this plane takes so long to start. It's apparently a key characteristic of the plane. So jealous of that thing. My friend told me yesterday that it's actually not very good in this game because it's too early war for it. When you can use it, it's already old in terms of technology. I don't know, it looks so cool. Ah, watch out, remember that this thing loves to spin. So accelerate steadily and accelerate enough so that he can actually... He stole his mom's credit card. Why is everyone flaming everyone else to buy all his aces? Aces? Accounts, no. Acts. He stole his mom's credit card to buy all the accounts. That's quite a tragic story, right? People even are creative when trying to insult one another in this game. So you have this incredible character that actually steals his mom's credit card. Imagine that. To come him and bother him to ring a match of Here to Stormwreck. Yes, yes, the internet is full with weird people to the brim, I tell you, to the brim. And let's open the radiator, yeah, because it's so hot right now. I opened it? No. Ah, the radiator is on the other button, yeah, on this plane. So I was flying without a radiator on. Open earlier. Which means the radiator is actually can stay closed. I don't know. And I didn't have trouble with the engine until the enemy shot it. Until the enemy shot the engine. It was cool that he died by crashing into me. Eh? In a way, it's almost like I got two kills. This plane is the quintessential dogfighter for me. I love the Tempest. Should play the British in War Thunder, really, to experience this side as well. Okay, we're going in the area where there are two objectives very close to one another. I guess that's where the action will be, and also where it was previously. In fact, he has more people going that way. Let's go with them. Ooh, it's the entire wing of P-38 that I saw, I think. Look at that. They're all P-38, right? A lightning storm. And a tempest. After the tempest comes the lightning, and so on, and so on. Where are they going, though? No, it's the right direction, more or less. I think I'm faster than the P-38 in the Tempest. I should be able to catch up, but I'm not 100% sure. Ah, by the way, am I smoking right now? A bit. Ah, yeah, so that's the reason I had trouble to stop it from smoking earlier. I thought I had opened the radiator, but I hadn't, because it's the other button. It's the button to the right for this plane. Yeah, you have them. Let's kick the enemy's ass. I wonder if they're carrying bombs as well. They might be. The P-38 is a good ground attack plane in this game. I love that Wings is now running these planes. I hope they will do it more often. Finally, the opportunity of playing with the more recent scenarios. Because it's the only populated server in the afternoon when I normally come and play this. That's not a lightning. I only see one tail. Well, these are friends. They're going to the railroad train station, and we are going to, in theory, the more the merrier, no? How is diving? What is she? Yeah, there's definitely fighting above the railroad station. We gotta be careful there. It's the one inside the city, right? Yeah. That's the railroad, so it will be that big building over there, I presume. Let's go above the clouds. Yeah, that looks very much like an attacker. Coming from the right way to be it as well. I will assume it's an enemy, even if I'm not sure. Wait, before dying, I gotta make sure. Damn it. No. No, it's the Mustang, okay. It's the Mustang. Never mind. It looks so menacing. Okay. Going back up then. That's the Mustang, right, huh? Oh shit. Well, that's certainly not a German plane. Actually, it looks like a Tempest. I think it's the same thing as me. Yeah, definitely, it's the Tempest. Like mine. Same thing I'm flying. What's that thing? That's a Lightning. Okay, this this target seems to be very well guarded. Why is the Lightning coming for me? I'm a friend! I'm a friend, man. Can't you tell? I think I'll climb after them. You best stay high. Wow, he smokes, eh, when you push it into combat mode. What's that? What's that? What's that? Enemy damage? Or a friendly damage? The direction is that of the enemy base, huh? Which makes it even more suspicious. Anyway, when you see someone going down like that, a kill has been achieved, so there is a 50% possibility that an enemy is involved. And there is stuff flying over there. Aplenty, at least three things. Okay, let's go above the clouds indeed. Breathing system on, yes. Go back into combat mode, we want to climb steadily. I have three contacts. Normally the one flying above is the enemy. But you know what? I think I saw the shape of a Lightning. And anyway, I cannot see it anymore. Okay, here you are. We're going very much the direction of the enemy airfield, by the way. I should check my six. I'm smoking a lot now. Slow down. Ah, I got a Linde mixture more. Of course, I'm high now. I got a Linde mixture. It should improve matters considerably. I still don't like how the medium level of zoom looks. Still have some trouble focusing. Despite setting the EPD with such care. Okay. I don't want to enter that situation because I couldn't see the enemy. Let's change direction often and look in every direction too. We're very much in danger right now, if it might not look like it. It's not a 110. Are there a few enemies or something? I don't understand. Where are they? Let me see the player numbers. There's a bit fewer than us, but not that many fewer. Damage this target plenty, by the way, eh? Probably between our first and second sortie with the Tempest. He seemed still standing when I last saw it. So someone is coming for it at the moment. What did it say? I missed it. Okay, who's winning here? Friend or foe? Because someone is definitely dying. Kicking the bucket right now. I gotta pull the stick very easy in a Tempest. Well, that's impossible to identify. No, the fire blinds me. And unfortunately I lost sight on the other guy. Here you are. It's a Spitfire or Tempest anyway, friend. Oh, he's diving for him. I think he's diving for him. And it's a Focke-Wulf. And it's a Focke-Wulf. Go, 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 go. Let's try to help him. I wish I could speak to him. Instead of only watching in horror, because that guy is dying very soon. There's another guy underneath me. Which is also German. I'll go for him. It's a better target. It's actually a very good target. Don't waste it. Okay, maximum speed. Confirmation of German. Wait a sec. That's a goddamn. Well, good thing I didn't fire. That's a goddamn Mustang. God damn it, it looks so German. The Mustang sometimes resembles the BF. Eh? In fact, I know the Germans hated it because of that. I read it once. The guy was 1 second from dying. Luckily, at the very last time I checked again. Damn it. Oh no, that's a friend, isn't he? He shot me, but it's a friend. Well, I will assume he's an enemy because he shot me. But to me, he looked like a friend. Here he comes. Oh, there's a lot of stuff up above me. I think I was shot at by a Tempest, honestly. But there's so many other things there. Okay, turn as tightly as only this plane can. I mean, look at it. Look how it flies. What am I following here? It's not German. Okay, the six are clear. Okay, what's happening there? They're engaging the German. That's German. That's not German. And the guy that got him is German. Oh god damn it, I lost him. Polish. I can't get an idea. That's German, god damn it. Yes. Right above my head. He's coming. No. He's not coming. He's going for someone else. Well, then I'll go after him. That's German, right? Yes. I don't know. The color of the tracer certainly seemed German, and he just got a kill. Oh, he killed my friend. try to punish him. Smoking hard, I'm also going a bit too hard. Let's reduce the throttle a bit. As even now, I'm not 100% sure. God damn it! Well, someone else was tracking me. I wish to cry. Okay. That was cool nonetheless. I came close, I think. That was an enemy, I believe. Okay. You know how it is. No, don't leave the server. Just respawn. Shall we pick a different plane? I don't know. I like this one so much. Damn, I was close, huh? I was close indeed. Or bomb. Is it time to bomb? I don't know. I would do another one of these. Then maybe we go bomb. I got only one air kill, right? The other two planes were packed. You got the Spitfire? I like the Tempest more, if I gotta tell you. He has a Spitfire right here. Nice livery, by the way. I like the Tempest because it's more powerful, and to me... You want to see the Spitfire? Well, okay, let's get the Spitfire. Yeah, let's do something different, not always the same thing. Okay, I'll get the Spitfire. Spitfire Mark 9, you made me change my mind. Let me see. I want that guy's livery most of all, the one with the angry mouth. Because I'm childish like that. Here it is. Yeah, Gibbs. You gotta have the cool livery. What else can he get? The better engine. And the mirror. And the gyro gun sight. The gyro gun sight is pretty cool. Okay, Spitfire time. Hey, you're still watching, Ash, by the way. Thank you. You watched the entire stream. Okay. I came so close. It's always the wingman that gets you. Always. The Spitfire has no mixture control, no. Well, this is more maneuverable. Such an iconic plane, after all. Yeah, you're right. When available, you gotta get the Spitfire at least once. This happens when the server has trouble updating. You gotta get the Spitfire at least once. British planes in general take long to start the engine. Well, this isn't as bad as the other one. Okay, the Spitfire is even harder to take off in. I gotta be careful, I broke so many of these things. Should I worry about the team? No, I think not. Okay, and now straight. I don't want to text you or do anything weird with this because I know that I will break it if I do. And off we go in the Spitfire, yeah, with the improved Merlin engine. What about the radiator? Does this plane have a radiator that you can control? No, it's automatic, I guess. Oh, that's annoying. Okay, I got it. You have trouble updating server. You don't have to keep telling me. Come on, I need an air kill. I need an air kill that I bring back to base. Please. Please give it to me. Go to the same place. The enemy seems really intent on destroying the railroad station. Don't shoot him, or server will die. Yeah, it's very close to happening, I think. By the number of updated failure messages. Yeah, you don't have the exact sight in the stream that I have. It's centered on the right eye, I think. If I look from the right eye, I see what you see. Unfortunately. Yet I remember clearly that I selected both eyes in Steam VR mode. Of mirroring. Apparently it doesn't always work. Okay. The fact is, when you're in these big dogfights, no, you do maybe a couple of passes, but then you gotta go away, because the probability of being engaged by one of the many enemies that are about is pretty damn high. Especially if you're alone. That's offended, I think. Disappear. Just the spotting ability that you would expect from Sturmory. South STH, heading west over the city low. They're still fighting above the railroad station, 100%. I wonder whether these are wingmen or those sworn enemies. Visual anymore. That's the city, and the station is there. I wonder whether I'm smoking. No, apparently the Spitfire is not as smoky as the Tempest. I don't see anything yet. Attention, the enemy attacked the railway station. Okay. I don't see any sign of bombing. We know that anyway, we knew it already. Okay, here you are then. The guy is mugging out. Let's hope for the better. did everyone go? I had two contacts and then suddenly I had none. Spitfire. That is a gentleman, I think. Oh, and there's suddenly many other contacts. What does it look like to you? I think it's a German. What happened? Someone got shot down and I lost sight on the other one. That's an enemy thing. Pull. Okay. I don't know if it's an enemy. Yes, he is. I saw the cross. And I thought that he's got a friend with him. How surprising. Yeah, you are. Hurry up. He crashed. What the fuck? And now the other one. He crashed. They even crashed when I could get the kill. No way, that's a maneuver kill. What's this? A freaking 110. Well, I can turn into 110 with a Spitfire. What do you think? Really? That's a 110 and dogfighting a Spitfire? I cannot believe my luck. Watch out, though. It's very heavily armed. And in fact, yes, he knew very well what he was doing. I think I was killed by a good player. Who was it? Stoltz. He's the first ranked in the game, yes. To get a kill like that with the 110, he had to be good. Wow. I'm starting to have some trouble here. Let's do a bombing run, I guess. Apparently today it's not going very well. Oh, he counted for a ditch and I didn't die, at least. What can I bomb? A fortified area, I guess. Let's bomb the fortified area. A20? Damn, with so many fighters, I don't know. No, tell you what, let's go to the southern targets, yes. With a Tempest again, because I enjoy it more, personally. I was sure I could get the 110, but that 110 knew what he was doing. Knew it very well. I can't believe the level of skill people have in this server. It's completely unlike War Thunder, where you meet unskilled people from time to time. If I didn't score these points in the beginning, I would be doing nothing since the beginning of the stream, baby. Okay. I gotta trust that the good time will come. Okay, rolling. Such a difficult game. Such a difficult game. Okay. Tempest again. Hey, thank you for the follow. Nicholas, thank you, very motivating. I'm having trouble, everyone is extremely good on the Wings of Liberty today. But perhaps I'll get another air kill, I wonder, before the end. Let's try. Let's try. I'm changing target, apparently there's some very dangerous pirates above our railway station, reason for which I'll go to the southern objectives and maybe find a more achievable prey. Also I hope, Wow. That duel with the Stolz guy, top rated German player, was really eye-opening. I have no idea how we managed to maneuver the 110 like that. I think I have more difficulty when it's a later war scenario, also because I don't know these planes as well, and that's the truth really. I played the Wings of Liberty so long with the early planes, and I don't know what I can and cannot do with this kind of vehicles. Come on, all I want is a kill. A kill. I was saying, how can he dogfight a Spitfire with a 110? Well, okay, he doesn't need to dogfight you if he kills you on the second pass. With perfect aim. Pinpoint accuracy. Okay, these are farther, huh? It will take some time to reach. But by now we are pretty much used to it. After all, this turmoil is not worth done. I couldn't find a single bomber. Everyone is doing the fighter role, it seems. Everyone. Probably they enjoy flying the late war fighters. Unfortunately, this makes also everything more difficult because a bomber usually is an easy kill. And there is none here that we can achieve. No easy kills today. Only difficult ones. I only see clear skies. It seems like everyone has gone to the northern objective. But then again, if we could have a one-to-one duel or something like that, it could be worth it. I guess I'll go towards Kells. It's on my way past the objectives after all. Keep looking and looking eventually, no? Yes. The game is running well despite the overlay, eh? I think it was unneeded. That thing that I did of removing the overlay every time. For sure I'm not doing it anymore. It's so convenient to have the overlay inside of the game instead of the cell phone. Hey, what's this Russian voice that I hear? It comes from the game, I hope. On the area of the Earthy Dash, see the enemy plant. Huh. Well, I actually turned around at a certain point. I'm not so far away from Ash. Also, I had disabled the chat by mistake. That's the reason I heard the voice, but I didn't see it. I don't want to join the huge dogfight above the railroad station because apparently there's far too much skilled people for me to survive in it. We gotta look for a different approach to the action. We gotta find someone that is isolated or maybe another group of players. It's never gonna work if I keep going there. I will only obtain defeat. So anything goes for me basically. Any kind of objective that is not that. If I keep overflying the center or part of the map eventually, like vulturing when the enemies would pass through, like that. What is that for instance? Ah. The way it's said it makes me think enemy. Okay, but I lost it. And no, I lost it. Of course it could have been a friend returning to base, huh? It was an isolated contact anyway, what I was looking for. Open the radiator, of course. Shall we go to the fortified area? Well, it's the closest objective at this point, we might as well. Too bad that I lost sight of that plane, and that looks interesting. Maybe I'll catch sight of it again. This medium zoom level is still wrong anyway, it doesn't look good. I could try to fix it honestly. Give me the other keyboard once. It was Alt F9, no? Yeah. And then Shift and think it's like this, honestly. I think, huh? But it says the train has been destroyed. Oh, now I like it. Now it's good. I think I fixed it finally. No, it's not the train I was looking at before, the one that has been destroyed. Ooh. Looks like a Mustang. Doesn't look particularly German to me. Also it's heading right back for base. Yeah, it's a Mustang heading for base. No, I look too much like a Mustang, it can't be anything else. Attention, the enemy attacked the southern group of troops. 2418, eh? Shall we head for it? Eh? I guess. By the way, turn on the cockpit lights. So that you can see the instruments. Let's go to this group of forces, alright. Cover is required. Square 2418. Ah, it's the one to the very south, unfortunately. Well, it's not so far, like 5 minutes at the most. Of course, the enemies could be long gone once I get there. Northern group of troops. Okay, now he's bombing the other troops as well. Might be a big bomber if he's attacking them both. Maybe I finally found the possibility of shooting a big bomber down. Well, if he's attacked the troops, now he will be trying to return to base, so... Troops were in the city? Yes. The big city, whatever city it is. So if I were this bomber at that point, I would have turned straight back to base, just to the left. See anything. It's the shortest stretch anyway. If you look at the enemy base and these troops, it's probably the next target they will go for. So it's not a bad place to guard, I guess. Now we're there, basically. Of course, the enemy is long gone. No visual, no visual whatsoever. Let's go toward the base. At this point, no? When worse comes to worse, at that point I find a plane, necessarily. I think my big mistake today was to keep going to the railroad station. When the enemy has air superiority there, as a single fighter, it's just impossible to survive. Impossible, because if they have air superiority, it means there are at least couples, if not entire squads, in constant communication. You arrive there alone, what do you expect to happen? I should have switched target immediately, and maybe I should have bombed more. And anyway, this game is like this. Sometimes the gears just don't come. Maybe bombing would have given me more satisfaction today. Gotta think about it next time. It's a different experience compared to Wartime. It's more immersive, but also way more difficult. Let's try to find. If I were the enemy, I would be spawning for Celts to attack the concentration of troops. It's two targets. Two targets is so close. Otherwise, we go raid Celts, I guess, for whatever it's worth. Too bad I'm not carrying bombs. That would have been handy. At this point I would fly low to avoid the spotting. But then again, this way I cannot spot either, not even the enemy I feel, which I will be approaching very soon. Very likely to be enemies. I hope they haven't seen me. I'm coming from an unexpected direction after all. Wait a minute, is that really German? Yes, yes it is. Come on. Come on, don't betray me. I should turn better than a BF, of course there's two of them. Can I turn better than two BFs, huh? Well, it's the Golden Tempest, after all it might. Okay. Okay now. Come on, final chance to score. Go for the one below, they might be already perfectly coordinated. He's the anchor and the other one is the hammer, of course. Let's try to get him at least. I fucking blacked out. I don't like it. I think I crashed. Well, that was my best chance, but unfortunately I squandered it as well. No, I'm still alive. The fuck I did. Okay. Yeah, but now he's on my turn. It was 1v2, of course, like every other one. And yeah, they got me. I can close. Once again, I can close. But close is not getting the kill, of course. And well, this concludes the stream. It's a frustrating game sometimes. Was a good attempt, I think. Still didn't work. Well, 10 minutes. We can do a quick dogfight on Berlog, at least I'll get some kills there. 10 minutes is plenty for Berlog. What happened is what I feared before. Unfortunately, I blacked out. Didn't black out so badly, but unfortunately badly enough. Came so close to killing that guy, so close. I should have done that from the beginning. If I went to that place instead of the other place, eventually I could have got the kill. But alas, it wasn't to be. There is no Berlog today. No quick fight whatsoever. Well, I wanted to do a quick fight. Let's do it as a quick mission, I guess. If it loads fast enough. But I want to be... Tempest. Oh! Tempest Mark II. Versus? I don't know. Put there some Fog Wolves and BS. Back then G14s, come on. It's just AI. Just to shoot something down. Sometimes it's frustrating, sometimes it is. You cannot deny the fact that it is. It's a difficult game. Portandre is more relaxing. At least we had a good bomber sortie, yeah. But I think we also were unlucky today, yeah? I met very skilled pilots. The things of meeting couples when you're alone is normal. It's normal. And, well, it almost worked that time. I can see how they got us so often. When you're flying with a friend, you feel safer. And if I were quicker there, I would have got at least one. Unfortunately, they reacted in time. Oh, don't take too long to load. I don't have so much longer. Playing this alone is like going into super hard mode, you gotta say that as well. Maybe single player is better, rather than alone. Would be certainly a more worthwhile practice, perhaps. At least I won't die every time I meet the enemy. That's so predictable, compared to real players. Sun in the eyes. This would be excellent practice actually. If I did some of these before going online every day, maybe I could achieve more. That's an enemy, right? Can I catch him? Yeah, I'm at Tempest. That's the Dora, he might be even faster actually. I hit him. Sometimes it can be difficult to hit the the AI, because they go into this very stable infinite turn where you gotta shoot underneath the nose of the plane, and it's not an easy feat. It's not an easy feat. Let's try to go faster so that I catch up. I won't be able to catch up on this guy. The AI doesn't really do much to escape. It sits there and waits for you to kill it. That's the truth. But it's the original problem with most flying games. I remember from back in the days, it was like that. It's always been like that. Once you're at someone's tail, if it's an AI, you can expect him to just fly straight or just keep turning, but in the same direction. Well, it's super easy in the end. And not that satisfying. But still good practice. What time is it? 57? Oh! Let's try to get another one, but I'll turn on the labels so that we can find them quicker. Ah, that one, maybe. I only have 3 minutes left. If only were this easy online. If only it were this easy to get on someone's tail. At least I used the Tempest a bit, no? My satisfaction, in the end I got it. 58, ooh, it's out of time. Come on. Don't overstress the engine or you'll break it. What distance? 80, come on, not so far now. Going down, woo! How was the external view again? I think I changed my controls and now I don't remember. Yeah! Didn't I have some way of... Oh, what did I do? I blacked out, of course. Well, I'm out of time. I'm out of time. It's a very, very cool game. It's a very cool game. It's also very difficult to play online, because people get extremely good at it, and most of all they play it together with friends. So even if you have basic skill like this, you still need more. You still need to read the situation correctly. I think if today I had gone for the isolated targets rather than a big dogfight, I would have enjoyed more success. In fact, I might have understood something that will be important for me going on. That's the thing. Don't join the big, busy dogfights if you're playing alone. Go hunting, because that hunt was very close to succeeding. And if I got one of these two, I bet I could have got the other one as well, because the Tempest outturned them. The only problem is that I had a single pass and I wasted it, but I came so close to succeeding. If I were doing that from the beginning, I would have got the kills. So yes, it's a difficult game, but also rewarding and very cool. I will certainly start playing it again from time to time. I mean, not every day, because it's so stressful compared to War Thunder. And speaking of tomorrow I won't be able to play in the morning, almost assuredly, and possibly not in the afternoon either, but we'll see. If I can, I'll be here. Otherwise, see you the day after tomorrow, I hope. These days are a bit strange for me. I gotta do, there are things that I gotta look after, but if I can, I'll play. And for now, thanks for watching this session. It's been good, difficult but good. I liked it. Let's have another soon. Bye bye, ciao from Italy, see you soon.